A very good afternoon. Welcome to the YouTube Live. So I hope I'm audible and visible to all of you. So myself, I'm Dr. Ramyashri. I teach obstetrics and gynecology. Right. Okay, so good. So in this session, I'll be discussing MCQs, a very good quality of MCQs, and more of OBS I have kept now. At 9 p.m. also, I'll be taking one more session. 9 p.m. we'll be discussing more of gynec questions. So we'll be doing like that. Okay. So I'll just give you a brief description on per the platform of Unacademy. On the platform of Unacademy, you have Plus subscription and Iconic subscription. Plus subscription is where you can get the access to daily live classes and structured courses, unlimited access, everything. Iconic is where you get Unacademy Plus Prep Ladder. And Unacademy is giving courses designed in such a way that it will be beneficial for all the students of different categories like FMG, Next, NEET, Crash Course. So there are plenty of courses, and we also have introduced a new live feature that is Raise a Hand. So not only you are going to listen to us, you can also speak to us. If you have any queries in the Plus class, you can raise your hand and ask your query. That's the one more advantage we have got. So before the prices increase, get the benefit. So you have 2 month calendar test and analysis batch. You have grand test series schedules. You have ultra fast track, high yield revision batches. So 2 month subscription, introductory offer of 6,750, whereas you also have 12 months if you buy 2 months free. You have professional year batches, target next batches, focus FMT batch, 4 year subscription. So you know they're designed according to the whatever, whichever benefits the students. And you can use the code of Ramya Live for further 10% discount, guys. Okay, right. So now it's almost like a special class itself, guys. We'll be discussing MCQs like special class itself, right? So let's start with the first question. What is the position in this? What is the position of the baby in this picture? So, Bagaraj, today we are having a special class integrated session between me and sir at around 7:30. Right, would you like to answer what is the position of this position? So, first and foremost, I always tell you, whenever you have to determine a position, always start with lie. So, it's a longitudinal lie. It's cephalic presentation. So as it is cephalic presentation, the denominator is vertex. As the denominator is vertex, the presenting part is vertex, so denominator is occiput. Now occiput is facing which side? It's facing the right side. So this is right, this is left. Ulta for us, right? So this is occiput is facing right side. Now, occiput is occiput towards the pubic symphysis or sacral promontory. Go step by step. Very good, Poonam and Arasan. So, occiput is facing towards the sacral promontory. As it is facing towards sacral promontory, you're going to call it as posterior. So, this is a picture of right occipito posterior. Understood? So, occiput is facing towards the sacral promontory. Occiput is towards the right side. So, that's why you're going to call it as right occipito posterior. Okay? Which of the following trigger onset of labor? So, there are many theories of labor, guys. There are many theories of labor. So, you have mechanical theories, you have biochemical theories. In biochemical theories, you have oxytocin, prostaglandin, relaxin, cytokines, and you also have fetal hypothalamo-pituitary-adrenal axis. Now, in this fetal hypothalamo-pituitary-adrenal axis, which acts as a trigger for the onset of labor? ACTH in the mother, ACTH in the fetus, prostaglandins, oxytocin. So, what is your answer here? Very good. Excellent, Poonam. So, here the answer is the trigger onset of labor is ACTH in the fetus. So, what happens here is so ACTH in the fetus, first CRH from the hypothalamus, you have corticotropin releasing hormone. The corticotropin releasing hormone will go stimulate the ACTH from the pituitary. The ACTH in the pituitary will go stimulate the adrenal gland producing DHEAs and cortisol. And cortisol, right? Now, what will happen to this? What will happen to this? This DHEAs will enter the placenta. In the placenta, with the help of sulfatase enzyme, this DHEAs gets converted into prostaglandins. Sorry, gets converted into estriol with the help of sulfatase enzyme. This estriol enters the mother circulation, where the estriol will increase the oxytocin receptors as well as oxytocin release. So, this is how it works. So, what is the trigger? Trigger is ACTH in the fetus or CRH, right? What does denominator refers to? Very basics, but yes, very important, and you cannot afford to lose a mark. What does denominator refers to? Part of presentation which lies over the internal os, relation of different parts of the fetus to one another. Bony fixed point of reference on presenting part. Part of the fetus lying in the lower segment of the uterus. Excellent. So, denominator is bony fixed point of reference on the presenting part. It is the bony fixed point of reference on the presenting part, right? So, on the presenting part, a bony fixed reference point, we call it as denominator, which determines the position of the fetus in the pelvis. So, for vertex, the denominator is occiput. For breech, it is sacrum. For shoulder, it is acromion. Okay, similarly, let's see the other also. Part of presentation which lies over the internal os. What does this mean? What does this mean? This is definition for part of presentation which lies over the internal os. Anybody? So part of presentation which lies over the internal os is called as presenting part. Presenting part. Very good, Ramesh. Excellent. Relation of different parts of the fetus to one another is called as attitude. Whereas part of fetus lying in the lower uterine segment of the uterus is nothing but presentation. So these are the different terminologies which we have, right? Intrauterine pressure during labor is raised to first stage 40 to 50, second stage 100 to 120, third stage 100 to 120, all of the above. So here, first stage 40 to 50 is correct, second stage 100 to 120, third stage also it remains 100 to 120. So that's why D is the correct answer. D is the correct answer. So at 40 mmHg, indentation of uterus is not possible. Pain perception will start at 15 mmHg itself. At 40 mmHg, the indentation of uterus is not possible. First stage may usually it is 40 to 50. Second stage it becomes double. That's 100 to 120. True regarding hypertonic dysfunction of labor is... most commonly associated with occipito-posterior position. Oxytocin administration is beneficial with occipito-posterior position. Occurs in first stage of labor. Leads to rapid dilatation of cervix. So hypertonic dysfunction means when you have more contractions, more than 5 contractions in 10 minutes. More than rapid dilatation, it causes fetal distress. So, which is the most appropriate statement here? Most commonly associated with OP, oxytocin is beneficial. Now, see, oxytocin is not beneficial here, beneficial because already there are contractions, right? So, when there are already contractions, there is no point in giving oxytocin again. It can lead to dilatation of cervix, but more it causes fetal distress. Yes, very good point asked by Sushant. So when you have hypertonic dysfunction, you can always give minimal tocolysis to stop those hypertonic contractions. So it occurs in first stage of labor is correct. It is associated with OP position, but not most common. So that's why C will be the most appropriate answer here. Next question. A 35-year-old pregnant female at 40 weeks of gestational age presents with pain and regular uterine contractions every 4 to 5 minutes. On arrival, the patient is in a lot of pain, requesting relief immediately. Her cervix is 5 centimeters dilated. What is the most appropriate method of pain control for this patient? So she's having severe pain. She's already 5 centimeters dilated. She's having regular contractions, so it looks like true labor pains. Very good. The best thing to do for pain relief is epidural block. Epidural block. So in epidural block, from which level do you anesthetize the woman? The level of block is at which level for epidural block? T4, T10, T12, S2. What is your answer? Very good. In epidural block, you block it from T10. The level of anesthesia blockade is from T10. Whereas for cesarean section, the level of blockade is from T4. For cesarean section, it is from T4. Whereas for epidural block, it is from T10, right? So epidural block is a good source of pain relief, but it has a side effect of postural. It has a problem of hypotension. It causes hypotension. So LSCS, the block is from T4. Epidural, it is blocked from T10. Pudendal block, what are the nerves which are blocked? Pudendal nerve, what are the nerves which are blocked? You don't require any investigation here. During labor, you don't require any investigation to start epidural. She's having pain, she's dilated, she's having unbearable pain. You can start her on epidural. Okay? Very good, excellent. Pudendal block is S2, S3, S4. And pudendal block, you give it around the ischial spine. So it's also called as what is the other name for pudendal block? Anybody? What is the other name for pudendal block? So pudendal block is also called as saddle block. Next question. Very good, Sushant. So, a 25-year-old woman whose antenatal period was uncomplicated is in labor. So 25, good age, her antenatal was also uncomplicated. She has a single fetus in cephalic presentation. Head is not engaged. Fetal heart rate is 150 beats per minute. Cervix dilatation is 5 centimeters. Cervix is 5 centimeters dilated. So she is a primie. Usually, when does the head engages in primie and when does the head engages in multi? Usually, when does the head engages in primie and when does the head engages in multi? Excellent, Peter. So primary around 37 weeks the head will engage, whereas multi the head will engage at the time of labor. So is this patient normal? Definitely not normal. Why? Because here the head is not getting engaged even at 5 centimeters of labor, right? So this is not normal. This is not normal. The membranes are absent, pelvis is adequate. It is decided to perform a cesarean section immediately. Which one of the following findings is most likely cause for this decision? Approximation of suture lines, palpation of anterior fontanella and sagittal suture, palpation of eyes, nose and mouth, palpation of frontal bones and supraorbital ridge. Okay, let's go one by one here. What does approximation of suture lines means? What does approximation of suture lines means? Okay, I see your answers ranging from D, C, B. Right, I'll come back to your answers. Excellent. Approximation of suture lines means molding. And that too, just approximation of suture lines means grade 1 molding. It's not like something severe molding also. It's just grade 1 molding, right? So we have three grades of molding. Grade 1 is just approximation of suture lines. Grade 2 is reducible overlapping of parietal bones. Reducible overlapping of parietal bones. Grade 3 is irreducible overlapping of parietal bones. Now, when would I have taken decision of cesarean section is if they would have mentioned that patient is having irreducible separation of parietal bones, then I would have gone for cesarean. Because grade 3 molding suggests that the patient is the baby is having CPD. The baby, there is either CPD or contracted pelvis. But as it is just grade 1 molding, it doesn't bother. It's no need to be bothered, right? Palpation of anterior fontanelli and sagittal suture, what does that mean? Palpation of anterior fontanelli and sagittal suture, what does that mean? Excellent, Peter. So, palpation of anterior fontanelli and sagittal suture means you're dealing with OP position. Do you require to do cesarean section for all OP positions? How much percentage of OP position can rotate and deliver normally? So we are already aware that 90% of OP position can rotate 3/8 of the circle and deliver vaginally. So for OP position also, you don't require to take the decision of doing cesarean section. Palpation of eyes, nose and mouth, what does that mean? Palpation of eyes, nose and mouth, what does that mean? It means you are dealing with face presentation. So face may mento anterior, no need of mento anterior can deliver vaginally, but mento posterior will require cesarean section. But here they didn't mention whether it is mento anterior or mento posterior. They just mentioned that it is face presentation. The next one, palpation of frontal bone and supraorbital ridge. So what is this? The last one, or D, it is palpation of frontal bones and supraorbital ridge. So what is this? This is bro. And in bro, you always go for LSCS. Why do you go in bro for LSCS? So I have taken a decision of cesarean because I understood that I am dealing with a bro presentation. Why in bro it is exclusively cesarean section, not vaginal delivery? Very good. Excellent, Peter and Poonam. Bro, it is mentovertical, which is 14 centimeters. So that head can never come out. That head will never come out. So better go for cesarean section. Okay. So it is mento vertical. Right, let's see the next question now. A woman undergoes induction of labor with amniotomy followed by oxytocin infusion at a period of amenorrhea of 41 weeks. 6 hours later, she is getting 4 contractions per 10 minutes and the fetal heart rate drops to 100 beats per minute. What is the first step in the management? Very good, excellent. So she's already, they have done ARM and then they've started her on oxytocin. So once you have started her on oxytocin, adequate contractions is when they have 3 contractions lasting for 10 to 15 minutes in lasting for 10 to 15 minutes in 10 minutes, right? So here you're having 4 contractions. 4 contractions is fine, but along with 4 contractions, you're having fetal distress. Fetal heart rate has dropped to 100 beats. So I want to reduce these contractions. Now, how am I going to reduce the contraction? By giving her tocolytic. But you don't require to tocolytic. First thing what you can do is, you can stop the oxytocin. Because oxytocin is the reason for excess contraction. So when she's getting adequate contractions and that to excess contraction, you don't require oxytocin. So excellent, all of you have answered correct. So here the answer will be D, stop the oxytocin infusion. Okay. Right. This session is for 1 hour, guys. So I'll be continuing till 3 o'clock. Identify the procedure shown in the image. Okay. If asked order, so actually already they are telling fetal heart rate is dropped to 100 beats. So probably they are doing. Yes, you are correct. Correct, Sushant. If they ask the order, I think you can go for D followed by C, followed by, you can also change the position of the mother. Why the heart rate is dropping to 100 beats? Cord compression. So when you change the position, probably cord compression is also relieved. So then you can answer it as D, C, B, right? Very good. So this is nothing but the Pollock's procedure. So somehow this is again many times asked. So you should be very, you should perfectly know about this. So the procedure which you're seeing in this picture is the Pollock's procedure. Right? So I'll just show you all the Leopold manuals. Pollock's procedure is which Leopold manual? Pollock's procedure is which Leopold, which? Very good. It is the third. Right? And it just tells us that whether the head is engaged or not engaged, whether the head is engaged or not engaged. So the first picture which you're seeing here is the Leopold first manure, and this is also called as this is also called as fundal grip. This is also called as fundal grip. So on fundal grip, if you feel there is a broad, soft, irregular structure, then what does it suggest? If you feel there's a broad, soft, irregular structure, what does it suggest? It means you are feeling the buttocks of the baby. If you feel there is hard, curved, and globular and palatable structure, then it is the fetal head. Whatever is there above, ulta will be there below. So indirectly it tells us about the presentation also, right? Now this is the Leopold second manure, where you are palpating the sides of the uterus. So this is also called as Leopold second manure is also called as lateral grip or umbilical grip. Very good, excellent, Raj, Ravi, Poonam, Peter. So it's also called lateral grip or umbilical grip. Very good, Sushant. So here, if you feel a smooth curvilinear substance, then it is the fetal back. If you feel multiple knob-like structures, then it is the fetal limbs. Third, this is the Leopold third manure, which is also called as pollex grip. So it tells us whether the presenting part is engaged or not engaged. It tells us whether the presenting part is engaged or not engaged. Or the first three manures are by seeing the patient's face. Only the last manure is by seeing the patient's feet. So this is the fourth manure. Fourth manure, if the hands are diverging, then head is engaged. If hands are converging, head not engaged. Okay. Yes, it can also tell whether the head attitude also. The attitude can be told by palpating the sinciput and occiput. The fourth Leopold manure can also tell us the attitude, and attitude can be determined by the sinciput, position of the sinciput and occiput. Okay, let's see the next question, guys. A 34-year-old nulliparous woman in second stage of labor has been pushing for last 2 hours and is exhausted. CTG is normal. Head is 1 centimeter above the ischial spine in OA position. Which of the following would be most appropriate action? So before you answer this, we will just revise the Very good, excellent, Peter and Raj Ravi. Very good, Peter. But I would quickly revise once regarding the second stage so that you know you can answer this question more better. So, second stage me. Mein... It is from full dilatation to expulsion of the fetus, right? So you have primi multi. So I asked you to remember for primi, ek, do, teen. 1, 2, 3. So primi, on an average, it takes 1 hour. Prolonged second stage takes 2 hours. Second stage arrest or obstructed labor is 3 hours. Multi, half of it, 30 minutes, 1 hour, 2 hour. Now this primary has already pushed for 2 hours and it is of no use, right? So what do you prolong second stage? You have to manage it. If station is below plus two, then you can go for instrumental delivery. If station is above plus two, then you have to go for LSES. Second stage arrest, LSES. First is Ridgeon's manual. Okay? If you go back, what is the station here? And what is the diagnosis here? Peter, you have answered correct, but station you have not answered correct. What is the station of the fetal head here? So this is prolonged second stage because she has been pushing for 2 hours. Very good. It is minus one. So there's no point in waiting any further because you have already waited 2 hours and it's a prolonged second stage and vertex it is minus one. So the best treatment here is doing emergency cesarean section. Okay. One more question, guys. A 23-year-old nulliparous woman has been pushing for 2 hours. Again, has been pushing for 2 hours. Head is not palpable abdominally. Good. Cervix is fully dilated and on vaginal examination, the head is in right occipito-posterior position with minimal caput. Station is 1 cm below the ischial spine. CTG is reassuring. Which of the following management option would be most appropriate? I'll change this little. The head is 2 cm below the ischial spine. Let me make it as 2 cm below the ischial spine. Okay, so this is also prolonged second stage, and I have told you station is plus two now because I've changed it to plus two, right? So you have to deliver her. You can put instrument. Now, where do you want to put instrument? Where do you want to put instrument? Labor room or theater? See, in such cases, instrument should be kept in the theater, guys, because instrument should be applied in theaters. Why? Mano, if there is something wrong and the forceps are not locking or there's a problem with vacuum, they can immediately do cesarean, right? if they, yes, it should be. I'll tell you about the station now, 1 minute. So it should be done in the theater, guys, not in delivery room. Okay. Now, one more question I have for you. Manu, you have applied forceps and it didn't lock. What will you do next? Will you go for vacuum? You have applied forceps, it didn't lock. What will be your next step? Will you go for vacuum? Or will you go for LSCS? So once you have applied an instrument and it didn't work, you have to go for LSCS. There is no drama like, oh, I have applied forceps, it didn't work, I'll go for vacuum now. No. Okay, so you have to go for cesarean section itself. Right? Okay, maximum how many times you can apply the vacuum before you tell it has failed vacuum, failed instrumental delivery. Maximum how many times you can apply the vacuum before you consider it as a failed instrumental delivery. Excellent, Peter. So maximum it is 3 times, 3 pop-offs you can call it as failed. Okay. Right, somebody asked me about the station. Yes. So ischial spine is considered as zero station. Ischial spine is considered as zero station. If head is above ischial spine, 1 centimeters above the ischial spine, -1. 2 centimeters above the ischial spine, -2. 3 centimeters above the ischial spine, -3. Agar head is above, it is bad, minus. If head is below, then it is a plus. +1, +2, +3. +3 means it's almost has come to the vulval outlet. +3 means it has almost come to the vulval outlet. Okay. Now we'll see one more question. A 37-year-old primary gravida, 37-year-old primary. What do you call a woman who is 37-year-old and primary? Yeah, in Bishop's Court you have station. Yes. So whenever you have a 37-year-old primary, we call it as elderly primary gravida. More than 35 years and a primary gravida, you call it as elderly primary gravida. You have to keep continuous fetal monitoring for twins. Elderly, so I have an answer of B here, okay. She's having irregular contractions. Irregular contractions means true labor pains or false labor pains. Irregular means true labor pains or false labor pains. Irregular means looks like a false labor pains, guys. False. Right, okay. She's 38 weeks pregnant. Ultrasound scan performed at 36 weeks shows that the placenta to be posterior and high. That is normal. Normally grown baby. She conceived by IVF. precious baby, right? Her admission CTG shows baseline of 145, variability of 10 to 15. Accelerations are present, no diesels. She's contracting once every 10 minutes. Vaginal examination shows cervix to be partially effaced and dilated 2 cm with intact membrane. Head is 5/5 palpable. All her observations are normal. Which of the following option would you do next? Okay, there are many things I would like to speak on this. First and foremost, she is elderly primary gravida and she is an IVF patient. So based on that, I accept that you all told it is a high risk patient. Wonderful. So it is high risk and it is precious pregnancy. But based on the history, is she in false labor pains or true labor pains? She looks like in false labor pains, right? Next point. Is her CTG normal or abnormal? So CTG is normal, right? Nirmala, I really appreciate your enthusiasm. And we also appreciate your willingness to become a doctor. Nothing, be dedicated. Do your biochemistry. No, you have chemistry, physics, and biology. So be perfect with those. Try to learn conceptual, then by hearting things. It's easy, okay? And the number of seats also have increased a lot. So if you read dedicatedly, definitely you'll get a seat. Okay, CTG is normal. Now, do you admit any patient with false labor pain, CTG normal? Ideally, if it is a low-risk patient, you don't even require to admit this patient because she has come to you with false labor pains and CTG is normal. So when false labor pains and CTG is normal, you can give her some sedation and send her home. And she is in first stage itself, latent phase, right? But here, I would like to admit her because she is a high-risk, precious pregnancy. And one more important point, why I would like to admit her, if anybody can tell, it will be very good. Why do you want to admit this patient? There's one point which is strongly suggesting that you have to admit this patient. Head is 5/5 palpable, means head is not engaged. And when head is not engaged and when you have contractions, what risk do you have? If you have sudden rupture of membranes, what can happen? When head is not engaged and if you have sudden rupture of membranes, what can happen? It can lead to cord prolapse. So I would like to admit her, but I will not keep her on continuous monitoring or neither I'll get her in labor ward. I'll just keep her in the antenatal ward. The answer here is A, guys, not B or C or D. So most of you have answered B, C, D, but no, it is answer A. Admit her to the antenatal ward. Head is 5/5 palpable means full above. It is mobile head. It is not engaged. If it is a low risk patient, you don't require to admit her. But as she is a high risk patient, you are admitting her. Okay? Something very similar to this also has been asked as an MCQ. In this patient, will it be wait and watch, or do you want to do cesarean section? After you admit her, is it wait and watch, or do you want to do cesarean section? It is just wait and watch. It is just wait and watch, right? So those were the MCQs which I wanted to discuss. We'll see one more question and end for this session. 32-year-old at 37 weeks in her first pregnancy is admitted for induction of labor as her baby has ultrasound confirmed intrauterine growth restriction. So IUGR. In early labor, the CTG shows baseline of 150. Variability of 5 beats and infrequent variable deceleration, dropping from baseline by 60 beats or less, taking 60 seconds to recover, and recorded over the previous 45 minutes. She is contracting once every 10 minutes and cervix is 1 to 2 centimeters long. What is the most appropriate next step? IUGR, and she's having diesels going up to 60 beats per minute, infrequent variable. So IUGR will be always associated with oligohydromnos, right? And this diesels, variable deceleration dropping up to 60 beats and all from past 45 minutes. What does this suggest? Why are we getting these contractions? Why are we getting these diesels? What does it suggest? What does it suggest? It looks like variable decelerations are seen in. So we have three types of excellent variable deceleration is suggestive of cord compression. Cord compression, that too at just once in every 10 minutes and fetal and IUGR. So do you think you can pull this till delivery? No. So what is the best thing you can do? It is perform an immediate cesarean section. Right? So we have three types of diesels, guys. We have three types of diesels. Early deceleration is suggestive of second stage head compression. Late diesel is suggestive of fetal distress. Variable deceleration is suggestive of cord compression. Right? So you should know these three basic things. Okay. So that's about today's session. So today, again at 7:30 on the Unacademy app. So you can follow me on the Unacademy platform. My name is Bezugam Ramyashri, guys. And you have entire course of obstetrics and gynecology discussed by me in the name of comprehensive course of obstetrics and gynecology by Dr. Ramyashri. Okay, so once you follow me, you'll get to know what are all the classes I've taken. And on the Unacademy app, today at 7:30, I'm doing an integrated session with Dr. Rajesh, who is a general medicine faculty. And today 9 p.m. we'll have another set of discussion like this for 1 hour where we'll be discussing some more MCQs and any particular topic which you want me to discuss MCQs or the same way is fine. Any particular topic you want for 9 p.m. discussion? Okay, I'll put some questions from preeclampsia. Right, no problem. So I'll try to keep some questions from preeclampsia. Okay. PYQs. Right. So we'll try to do some questions of preeclampsia and PYQs in the evening session. Partogram, I think I've recently discussed in a partogram. If you go to my special classes, you have partogram and CTG. Even on YouTube also, I've discussed partogram. So if you just write partogram Dr. Ramyashree, I think YouTube mein aa jayega. Okay. So I'll try to incorporate the most important questions which are very important and like, you know, which might come again for our NEET. Okay, so let's make OBG is a strong subject so that we get a perfect score in OBG and we get a best rank. So keep studying, guys. I'll see you all again at 9 p.m. and 7:30 p.m. Thank you. All the best.